Welcome into BLTV Channel 6. I'm Brian Kell. We have reached out to many candidates throughout our service area for contested races that are going on, and this is one of those interviews. This is one of those candidates. With us, a candidate for one of three open City of McMinnville board seats, Carrie Morton. Carrie, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah,
I'm enjoying this. This is great.
Tell us about you.
Okay. Well, let's see. I guess if anybody knows me, it's going to be me, right?
Yeah.
So I was born and raised in Warren County. All through my high school years, I was on the Pioneerette dance team. Miss Patty Clark was one of my, well, she was my instructor, my drill sergeant, so to speak. I was able to go through the Lake T.E. McGee's marketing class. That's where I kind of started my business at, I want to say, because I actually was able to go through and build a salon during that time. So I use a lot of the things that I learned from him back in that day still today. I graduated in 1985 and I went straight to cosmetology school. I was able to work with Gail Yates, who mentored me for many years after that. I've owned my own hair salon for 20 years. I'm married to Bobby Morton. We have two girls, two grandchildren, wonderful grandchildren. And I have a strong conservative Christian values. I'm a member of the Mount Leo Church of Christ.
Good deal. What are people telling you are the most important things that they want to see happen in the City of McMinnville?
So the people are telling us exactly what the survey said. We had a survey done back April, maybe even a year ago, April. And the street paving was number one, sidewalks was number two, and the storm drainage system was number three. So those are the biggies. Everybody here in town knows of a pothole or two that's about knocked a tire out. So those things, of course, obviously, you know, all infrastructure. So there are lots of things that were on the list, but those were the top three.
So infrastructure, very important. You've already mentioned that, especially when it comes down to the survey that was done. Do you have some specific goals kind of set out there over the next 4 years for the City of McMinnville when it comes to infrastructure?
Yes, I think the streets need to be paved. We have the, I better say this right, the American Rescue Plan money, aka COVID money, that I think could really boost us into seeing a lot of street paving done. There have been a lot of years that we've done zero street paving, or very little to say the least, not enough, and we're kind of behind the eight ball on that. We need to ramp it up. So that is one thing. There have finally, and I'll talk more about my stormwater drainage at the end, but they've finally had some engineer come in and talked with us about finding some things and that the city has not done over the years to make sure those things are cleared to where businesses and homeowners won't have that damage. So those, and sidewalks are kind of addressing that right now. The sidewalks are getting, they're getting taken care of.
Mm-hmm. McMinnville's been fortunate to see growth in tourism, which helps in growing revenues. Do you have any plans that kind of help on that front, and just your thoughts on tourism in the City of McMinnville?
We have a lot of things to see, a lot of nice places to go. We have fabulous restaurants. Of course, you know, kayaking is huge here in the spring, summer, even in the fall. The Cumberland Caverns, you know, lots of nice, our downtown is beautiful. Setting up for Relay for Life down there, I've talked to many people who are here from, you know, out of state, or what's going on. So those types of things like that are really good. It helps bring in a lot of revenue here. The tourism board itself is self-funded. So I think, kind of like with the ice skating rink, they'll bring things to the table to discuss things like, you know, we need your help with this, or can we do that? So that's where the city will step in when it comes to that.
The homeless issue, it's been a topic of a lot of debate recently. Any thoughts on how that could be tackled in a better way or the same way? Just your thoughts on the homeless situation.
Okay, so this is a really hard one because, you know, we've had some struggles with this over the last little bit. I think this was the hardest question that I had to address because I don't know that there is a real solution to the problem. Many of the homeless people that we have here in our town aren't from here, and all of them have different circumstances. I know we have a home organization that is working with as many of them as possible. I do encourage anybody out there that's listening, if you have some volunteer hours to spend, please reach out to those folks. I'm sure they can help you. Sometimes it's a one-man show around here on getting things done. So I think that organization is doing an awesome job. But our overall goal is to keep our residents safe. I will tell you that over the last week, my thoughts have changed from one end of the spectrum to the other with the forest fire on the mountain. We have all kinds of people who are homeless for different reasons. You know, some want to get back on their feet, and there are resources that are available for that. Some want to get back home. I've heard of a story where somebody just wanted to get back home, and they were helped to do that. Unfortunately, some are drug addicted. There's resources available for that also. And, you know, realistically, some just want to engage in criminal activity, which, like I said, was one of the things that we all experienced this weekend. You know, the man knew he was trespassing, didn't obviously care, put hundreds of my family and my firefighter families in danger. And, you know, if we're going to keep our crime rate low, we have got to have law and order here. So I think law and order is number one always, and then the resources that are available to help the rest of them.
Mm-hmm. Are you a no new taxes person, no matter what, or does it depend on the situation that the city could find itself in?
I say no new taxes, and I'll tell you, I think there's some wasteful spending going on. I have been going to many meetings over many years, and I think once you sit down and you look at the numbers, you're going to see maybe this that can be pulled out or that can be pulled out. So it's going to be, you know, on a local level, just like it is with state and federal, you know, there's going to be some things in there that, is this necessary? I see them spending money sometimes on plans or, you know, let's get a study or whatever. And, you know, especially on things that aren't really happening right now, I think money like that shouldn't be spent. So I just say no.
Okay. Working with others of different mindsets can be very important in local politics. Do you have examples of working with people of different perspectives than yours? Or if not, how would you maybe plan to do this if you feel it's important?
Right, well, first of all, I'm in the service industry. Mm-hmm. So I've grown hairdressers. So different personalities, and I have a new person in my chair every 30 minutes, 45, an hour, whatever. So I deal with a lot of people that way. I'm also on the board of the Harrison Ferry Fire Department, volunteer fire department, and the community center there. I'm on the Laurel Creek Cemetery board, and I have a leadership role in Relay for Life. So a lot of people have seen me over the years, busy, going, doing, getting, fetching, all that stuff. And, you know, we have a lot of people that bring ideas to the table, and we sit there, and that's what we have to do. We just have to go through things, and I feel like I work well with other people.
Mm-hmm. Preliminary reports have shown that the Morford Street phase of downtown McMinnville revitalization would cost over $15 million. And kind of a quote here, I think that Mr. Ming mentioned in the Southern Standard story on this, mostly funded through grants. Are you for pushing forward with this project or not, and why?
So I am not for pushing forward with this project right now. I do know there are grants out there. Grants used to be a taboo word. Everybody, no, we don't want grants. Well, grants are going to be given. So I feel like, and it's our tax money that funds the grants. So I feel like if anybody's going to get grants, McMinnville should get its fair share of the grant money. But at this time, I don't think that is something that we need to be discussing when we don't have the proper infrastructure in many places of McMinnville. So if we start there and then we shift something somewhere else it doesn't need to be, I think we're going to be in a lot of trouble that way. So I'm not against the downtown, that phase three. I just say we've got a lot of stuff to fix before we get to that point.
Gotcha. Appreciate your time and coming here with us and spending this time. Maybe just, we've got probably a few minutes here left in this interview. Maybe speak to the person out there that's watching right now as to why you feel you're the best person to be elected to the McMinnville City Board.
Well, I have been attending the Alderman meetings for 5 years. I've listened and learned what has worked and what hasn't worked in our city government. Problems with the lack of stormwater drainage is what got me involved. I have done a lot of research. I believe I can be part of the solution to that infrastructure storm upgrades as we need them. I've also watched the leaders of the city sit by and not promptly address problems that we need. They want to start pushing it down the road. I do appreciate everybody's time that they give to the board, but I do think sometimes it's time to get different people in there to have some different ideas and some different goals. I think we're all on the same team. The government should be proactive, working efficiently for all of its residents. I believe it is time for a change, and you have the opportunity to make our McMinnville the best ever. I would greatly appreciate your vote on November the 8th or before, and I would also like to thank Ben Lomond Television for allowing us this time to speak with you today.
Carrie, thanks so much. Appreciate it. And we thank you for watching here on BLTV Channel 6. I want to remind you that Tuesday night, 7 p.m., November 8th, we will have multi-county election coverage here on Channel 6. And we will be doing live updates from the Warren County Election Commission. So we ask you to join us Tuesday night, November 8th, at 7 o'clock. We look forward to seeing you then. And thanks for spending time with us here on BLTV Channel 6.